Welcome to Morningstar. I'm Holly Black. With me is Richard Colwell. He's manager of the Threadneedle UK Equity Income Fund. Hello.
Hello there.
So, Richard, we sit here at the end of 1 year and the start of the next. Can you tell me, what is it like to be a UK equity income investor in 2020?
Well, it's been very lively, very exciting. Those of us who were investing through the financial crisis a decade ago thought that was the bone shaker to end all bone shakers, but turns out that was just a warm-up act, really. So, hell of a thing for everybody to process, and you learn a lot about yourself and your team in terms of how we've coped with the pressures and trying to assimilate huge uncertainties in terms of how you approach valuation of companies.
So I can understand investors might not want to make predictions for the year ahead, being as 2020 had so many surprises. But looking to 2021, which areas are you feeling most positive about? Where do you think the opportunities are?
Gosh. At the risk of sounding like a broken record, actually, a lot of what we were saying this time last year, I would still hold is true. We are already seeing evidence of overseas corporates and private equity sniffing around great franchises that are available at very attractive valuations because of this kind of double discount that the UK equities sits on because of Brexit over the recent 4 years or so, and now COVID. And therefore, it's in some ways it's frustrating, but it's also exciting that, I don't think we need to worry about really the magnitude of the economic recovery, the nuances of what a post-Brexit world looks like. We're just cheap, pound for pound, every sector relative to its peer group overseas. And therefore, I don't think the value opportunity is in a relatively narrow set. I think it is across the wider UK market.
So lots to be positive about. But what are the challenges? Where are you more cautious for the year ahead?
Well, you're always looking for shadows. Unfortunately, didn't see the one that was staring us in the face this time last year. But I suppose it's that there is a degree of euphoria. There is the old don't go against the Fed. It's sort of the notion that policymakers have got our backs. Well, arguably we might look back and say they made mistakes and overclubbed things. So. It's always right to be wary. If it's too good to be true, it usually is. So that's why I think UK equities is a good place, really, in the sense that we don't have that euphoria. We don't really have lots of valuation overstretch that, arguably you could see in other markets. I mean, in the great balloon debate, regardless of your politics, UK is at a 20-year low against Europe. I mean, that's just that's just mad.
Richard, thank you so much for your time. For Morningstar, I'm Holly Black.